Morning all of you. Today we will start exercise 8.2. This is the 8.2 fifth question. In this question it says that a VCR and a TV were bought for rupees 8000 each. Means suppose this is VCR and this is TV. So the cost of VCR and TV were bought for 8000 each. Means VCR was also 8000 rupees and television was also for 8000 rupees. The next line it says that the shopkeeper made a loss of 4% on the VCR. The shopkeeper, he made a loss of how much? He made a loss of 4% on VCR, but and the profit of 8% on the TV. In VCR he is getting loss of 4%, but in TV he is getting profit of 8%. Okay, so what you have to find the gain or loss percent on the whole transaction. We have to find out for this whole transaction whether it is gain or loss. Okay, so first we will go step by step. As this is a long process, I will be going step by step. So first we will take for VCR. Okay, for VCR cost is given 8000 rupees. So I will write the cost price as CP. So what is the cost price of the VCR? It is 8000 rupees. This is 8000 rupees. Similarly, he is getting a loss of 4% here. Means loss percent is how much? 4%. Okay. So here we have given the loss in percentage. First, we will find out the loss in numbers. So for loss, what we have to do? We have to find out 4% of CP. Whenever we found the loss or the profit, we find it on the actual fine or on the cost price. That is here on the cost price. So first, 4% of cost price is 8000. Okay. So here loss equal to 4/100. 4/4% is 4/100. Of means into 8000. So this zero gets cancelled, this zero and this zero gets cancelled. So loss is equal to 4 into 8. So this is 8 4s are 320. So he is getting a loss of how much? 420 rupees. Now we have to find out the selling price. Selling price is equal to SP. What is selling price? Selling price equal to cost price minus loss. Okay, for loss we will subtract and for profit we will add in the cost price. So here what was the cost price? Here cost price is given 8000 rupees. So 8000 rupees here, and what is the loss? 320. Okay, so subtract this, how much you will get? 8000 minus 320. Subtract this, this is 7 9. 10 minus 2 is 8, 9 minus 3 is 6, and this is 7. So what is the selling price of the VCR? Selling price of the VCR is 7680 rupees. Second portion, first we have taken out for the VCR. Now we will go for the television. This is for TV. So what is the cost price given for the television here? You know, it was 8000 rupees for each. So cost price of the television is 8000 rupees. There it was given in VCR, it was given loss of 4%. But here in the television it is given profit of 8%. Okay. Here in the television it is given profit of 8% on the TV. Finally, what we have to find out? Profit is given in percent. First we will find out the profit. So profit, I told you, we always take it for the cost price. So here profit is given 8%. 8% of what? 8% of the cost price. So cost price is here 8000. So 8 upon 100 into 8000. This 0, this 0, this 0 and this 0, it got cancelled. So 8 into 64, this is 640 rupees. So how much profit does he earn? How much rupees of the profit he earns? It is for 640 rupees. Similarly, I told you here we will find out the selling price. So I told you selling price means if it is loss, you have to subtract from the cost price, and if it is profit, you will add it on the cost price. So this is cost price plus profit. So cost price here is 8000 rupees and profit here is 640 rupees. This is 640 rupees. So what is the selling price here? Selling price here is 8640 rupees. Now here we know the selling price of both the television and VCR. Similarly, we know the cost price of both the television and VCR. So here, if I take out cost price of both television and VCR, because we have to find out for the whole transaction. So cost price of VCR plus television. So what is VCR given here? What was the cost price of VCR? What was the cost price of the VCR here? Cost price was 8000 plus for television also it was how much? 8000 rupees. So cost price of television plus VCR is how much? 16,000 of the cost price for the sellers VCR plus television. Similarly, we have to find out the, as we have taken out the cost price for VCR plus television, that is 8000 plus 8000 is 16,000, that is the cost price of both VCR and television. Similarly, here I have taken out the selling price of VCR and television. VCR, we have taken out the selling price as this much, and for television is this much. On adding, we got the selling price of both the VCR and television. You know, if we have to find out gain or loss percent, what we have to see? We have to see if selling price will be greater than cost price. So this will be the condition of profit, okay? And if selling price will be less than cost price, so this will be the condition for loss. Suppose if you purchase a pen on 10 rupees. Suppose you purchase a pen on 10 rupees. This is the cost price of the pen, okay? And after you have purchased this in 10 rupees and you sold it to your friend in 15 rupees. That is selling price of this pen. Cost price means you have purchased this for rupees 10. And selling price that you have sent this pen to your friend in rupees 5. So here you have to find out you are getting loss or you are getting profit. So you know this selling price is greater than cost price. So this is the condition of profit. How many rupees profit means 50 minus 10 is 5. So 05 rupees profit you have earned. Similarly, this is in that condition only. Okay. Selling price, if selling price is greater than the cost price, you will find profit. If selling price is less than cost price, you will find loss. Similarly, same example I'm going to take. If you have purchased a pen on 10 rupees and you sold it to your friend on 5 rupees, okay, your cost price was 10, but you sent it to your sold it to your friend by rupees 5. So here you can clearly see that you are getting 5 rupees loss. So here you can see that cost price is greater than selling price. Okay, so here in this condition you will face loss. Okay, so similarly, here also we will check. See, here selling price is given this much and cost price is given this much. In both of these conditions we have to see which one is greater. So I have given you the profit also and loss also. So just check. What is the selling price? Selling price here it is given as 16320 rupees. And cost price here it is given as 16000 rupees. Subtract this, you will be remaining as 320 rupees. Now you can see, in this condition, selling price is greater than the cost price. Means this first condition it is fulfilling. So here you are in the condition of profit. So here you got profit of rupees 320 rupees. Now what you have to do, you have to find out the profit percent. Profit percent, how you will find out? Suppose, let's say, you are given with profit and you are given with cost price. You have to find out the profit percent. For finding out the profit percent means the profit which you have got upon, you have to find out the cost price. Cost price means that also total cost price. So total cost price of both means VCR and television is how much? 16,000. So upon 16,000 into 100, this zero gets cancelled, this zero and this zero get cancelled. Here can see 16 ones are 60, 0, 16 twos are 32 and 0, 10 ones are and 10 twos are. So how many percent profit you have? The shopkeeper has, he has 2% profit on the whole transaction, that is for by the gain or loss percent on the whole transaction. So here we are getting gain and how many percent? 2% on the whole transaction, that is VCR plus television both. This is question number 6. Here in this question it says that during a sale, there was a sale, a shop offered a discount of 10% on the mark price for all the items. Means here discount the shopkeeper is giving in all the items is how much? 10%, okay? What would a customer have to pay for a pair of jeans marked at rupees 1450, okay? What we have to find out? We have to find out what would a customer have to pay, okay? If he purchase a pair of jeans and that pair of jeans cost price is how much? 1450. And two shirt mark price is this. And for jeans mark price is given as rupees 1450. And for two shirts, means two shirt he is purchasing, and for two shirt he will get, the mark price is this much, and both the item he is getting discount of 10%. So what we have to find out? That how much that customer have to pay for a pair of jeans and a two shirts of mark price, means for a pair also and for two shirts we have to find out the how much the customer have to pay. So first we will start one by one, okay? So here what it is given, we will go for jeans, huh? First we will go for jeans. So jeans mark price or cost price, you can say it is given as rupees 1450. Mark price and cost price is same. Don't be confused that what is ma'am, what is mark price, what is cost price. Mark price and cost price is same only, okay? Either you can write cost price, either you can write the mark price. So here at the cost price or mark price is given rupees 1450, means 1450 here you are given with cost price, and discount you are given with how much? 10% you are given with the discount. You have to find out the selling price. First I will find out the selling price. So selling price is what? Okay, so what you have to find out? The selling price. Selling price means okay, first what you have to find out? You have to find out the selling price. Selling price means cost price minus, okay, 10% of cost price, okay? 10% of cost price is, from here we will find out the discount, and from the actual cost price, if I subtract the discount, I will get the selling price of this. So what is the cost price here? Cost price is 1450 minus 10% of cost price is you can cancel it. This 0 and this 0 can cancel, this 0 and this 0 can cancel. So this is 1, 4, 5, 0 minus 1, 4, 5, 0. Sorry, here minus 1, 145. Sorry, here it is given 1450. You have to subtract it with 1450. Subtract with 145. So let's subtract. What you will get? 1450 minus 145. This is 4, 10 minus 5 is 5, 4 minus 4 is 0, 4 minus 1 is 3, and this 1. So what is the selling price of the jeans? Selling price of the jeans is 1305. So here we are there with 1305 rupees. Means this is selling price is 1305. Means a pair of a jeans will cost how much rupees? 1305 rupees. After discount, okay? After discount, you will get this much rupees. Now we have to find out for the shirt. This is shirt. But see, here we are given with one pair of jeans, but and rupees for one pair of jeans. And two shirts mark prices. This means two shirts are there. So how many shirts? Two shirts, okay? So 850. Plus 850. So two shirts is 5 to 10. 1700 for two shirts. That means cost price of the shirt is how much? 1700 rupees. Again in the shirt also you will get discount. So discount is how much? 10%. Okay. So we have to find out the selling price. Selling price is how much? I told you cost price minus 10% of cost price, okay? So what is the cost price here? 1700 minus 10 upon 100 into cost price. Cost price again here is 1700, okay? Now what you can do, you can cancel this 0 and this 0 gets cancelled, this 0 and this 0 gets cancelled. So here you will remain with 1700 minus 170, okay? Now subtract 1700 minus 170. 10 minus 7 is 3. 6 minus 1 is 5. This is 1530. So what is the selling price after discount of this both the shirts? That is 1530 rupees. Now you are there with selling price also, both the selling price and both the cost price. Okay? What we have now, here you are with the selling price of the jeans also, and here you are with the selling price of the two shirts also. What you have to find? What would a customer have to pay on both these? You have to, what payment he have to give? So first we will find out the total. So he is asking how much he have to pay. So what you will do? We will add this for jeans and for shirt. Add this, you will get 5382. 2835 rupees is the answer that the customer have to pay for a pair of jeans of rupees this much and two shirt marked at rupees 840 each. Okay, this is question number 8. Here in this question it says that the price of a television is rupees 13,000. The sale tax charge on it is at the rate of 12%. Here the price of this television is how much? 13,000 rupees, okay, and in this he has added sale tax, that is of 12%, okay. Whenever you purchase something, this sale tax is added. Why? If you say, madam, this sale tax, the shopkeeper should be paid. Why? That person will, why this Vinod will pay this sale tax? But whenever you purchase something, you just check on your bill. Already it is given that the sale tax is added on this thing, added on the original price. So here what is given, a television is cost this much and the sale tax is how much? 12%. 12% is the sale tax. So here it is given in percentage. First we will find out the sale tax in the amount. So how you will find out the sale tax in the amount? So I am writing amount of tax is equal to 12% of this, that is 13,000, that is 12 upon 100 into 13,000, this 0 gets cancelled, this 0 gets cancelled. Now multiply into 12, 2, 3, 2 are 6, 2 ones are 2, 0, 3, 1, 6, 1560 is the amount. 1560 is the amount of the sale tax. What we have to find? Find the amount that Vinod have to pay if he buys. If Vinod is buying this television, how much amount he will have to pay to that shopkeeper? So you know, if we buy this television, we have to pay this 13,000 rupees also and plus this sale tax which costs for 12%. So now we have find this 12% in the amount, that is 1560 rupees. So if Vinod have, how much money Vinod have to pay, means Vinod will pay how much money for television, that is 13,000 plus the sale tax, that is rupees 1560. Now add this. Okay. So I am adding, what you will get? 1300006516541. Means he will pay 14,560 rupees if he purchases this television. Okay, I am repeating this question. Okay. The price of the television was this much and sale tax was 12%. Here it was given in 12%. It was not given in the amount. So first I have converted this 12% of this cost price. So this is amount of the taxes, this much rupees. If Vinod will purchase this television, we have to pay the sale tax. So television plus sale tax is this much. Okay. So this is question number 9. Here in this question it says, Arun bought a pair of skates at a sale where the discount was given 20%. Means what is given here? Discount it is given. How much? 20%. Arun bought a pair of skates. You know what is skates, na? So Arun bought a pair of skates. Sales where the discount was given. Here it is not given that at what price he has bought or whatever. It is not given. Here only given. Here it is given the discount at. Discount is given 20%. If he pays rupees 1600, if he pays means if he is purchasing it with rupees 1600, okay, we have to find out the mark price, and you know this mark price or cost price, so you have to find out. So what you will do, suppose let the mark price be how much? X. Okay. So what is given if he pays this much rupees? So find the mark price. So mark price means if this is the total cost price, okay, and from this total gross price he is taking 20% of discount on this cost price. Suppose this is the cost price, okay, on this he is taking 20% of 20% discount on this cost price. So it will be equal to how much? 1600. Okay, this is the equation. So what you will do, you will solve the equation. X minus 20 upon 100 of is multiply x is equal to 1600. Here what you will get? Okay, here is x upon 1 minus 20x upon 100 equal to 1600. Now here I am solving it. Okay. So from here you can see, you will get, take the LCM, here is 100. Now we will take LCM, this will be 100x minus 20x equal to 1600. So 100 minus 20 is 80x upon 100, that is 1600. Okay. Now cross multiply and find the value of x, that is the cost price. This is 80. X into 1 is equal to 1600 into 100. X is equal to 1600 into 100 upon 80. This 0 and this 0 gets cancelled. 8 1s are 8 2s are 16. So X is equal to 2000 rupees. So what is the mark price or the cost price? Mark price or the crosses or the cost price is 2000 rupees. Here this is question number 10. In this question it says that I purchase a hair dryer of rupees 5400 including 8% VAT tax. Means suppose I am purchasing a hair dryer, what is the cost of the hair dryer is rupees 5400, okay? But after this he is including tax of VAT 8%. Now you will say, madam, what is VAT here? VAT is a kind of tax that is full form is value added tax, okay? So on purchasing a hair dryer, VAT means 8% tax is included. Find the price before VAT. Means this is the price when tax is added. 8% tax is already added here, okay? And this is the price where this 8% tax is already added here. What we have to find out? We have to find out the value added, we have to find the price before this VAT was added. So how we will find out? It was seen that I purchase a hair dryer of rupees 5400 include 8% of VAT tax. Find the price before VAT was added. And before only I told you what is VAT, VAT is value added tax. And when I purchase a dryer for rupees this much, this tax was already included in this, means VAT tax of 8% was already included on that 5400. I have to find the price before the VAT tax were added. What was the value of that hair dryer unless and until this 8% VAT tax was not added in that price? So for this I have taken, let the mark price be X. So X plus 8% of X is 500. Now you will say this is mark price or cost price. Why I have added plus here? Plus means because on this cost price 8% tax is added and then this total amount is 5400. That's why here plus sign is there. So X plus 8 upon 100 into X is equal to 5400. Again take LCM. Here you will get X 100X plus 8X equal to 5400. Okay. Now 100X plus 8X is 100 and 8X upon 100 equal to 5400. Now what you will take? X equal to cross multiply, you will get 5400 into 100 and this 108 will come here. So I am not solving this because it is too lengthy calculation. So do one thing, after solving this calculation you will get the value of X as 5000 rupees. When you will solve this you will get the value of X here as 5000 rupees. So what is the price of VAT tax? What was the price before VAT tax was added? Before VAT tax it was 5000 and after adding 8% of VAT tax it was rupees 5400 rupees. Okay, so we have to find out before. So before means the value of X is 5000 and when 8% will be added it will be 5400. So with this I finish this exercise 8.2. Solve all the questions of 8.2. If you have any doubt you can ask me.